Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Chinese EV maker XPeng after it reported its vice president was suspended amid a probe related to corruption. But the U.S.-listed firm asserted the incident affected a small area and did not hit business and production links. That assurance helping XPeng in pre-market trade with its shares up nearly 2%. Also in focus, PepsiCo, which raised its full-year guidance after reporting third-quarter earnings and revenue that beat Wall Street estimates. Shares of the snack and beverage giant are up 2% before the bell. And we're also keeping a close watch on Mercedes-Benz. That's after it said sales dipped slightly in the third quarter on model changes and lack of parts. Investors, though, seem to be shrugging that news off, with shares of the firm up 2% in midday trade. Another German carmaker seeing its shares surge. BMW reports group sales of its battery electric vehicles surged by nearly 80% in the third quarter. BMW shares are currently trading higher by 3%.
Asian markets ended Tuesday trade mostly higher as the Federal Reserve's dovish tone eased rate expectations, temporarily lifting sentiment that has been dragged by the Israel conflict. Japan's Nikkei jumped nearly 2.5%, boosted by energy and distribution stocks. Australia's ASX 200 and Singapore's Straits Times Index rose 1% each. Some notable stock movements in the region. Hong Kong-listed Country Garden saw its shares plunge for a second day after China's largest property developer warned it can't meet offshore debt obligations. Now, this raised worries it will join a growing list of Chinese developers that have defaulted. Meanwhile, some stocks of airline firms in the region tumbled after they were forced to cancel flights to Israel due to the conflict there. In more positive news, shares of Samsung Electronics rose on news South Korean chipmakers were given the go signal to continue shipping U.S. chip gear supplies to their China factories without additional permits. Here at home, Philippine shares gained a 0.5%, with advancers outnumbering decliners.
Compared to how the markets reacted previously with the war in Ukraine, the market has been doing pretty well. It's also mainly because probably that the supply chains aren't as affected as it has been with the conflict in the Ukraine, because Israel and Palestine aren't really oil producers. Okay. It's more of Iran and Saudi Arabia, which don't really see the conflict landing on their territories. Resilience that we saw in the PSE this session could be attributed to the upcoming third quarter earnings. So investors seem to have high hopes for a favorable third quarter, which would offset the Israel-Hamas conflict worries.
The Filipino-Chinese business group is worried the Israel-Hamas war will negatively impact the global economy. The Federation of Filipino-Chinese Chambers of Commerce and Industry predicts business confidence and world oil prices may take a hit, similar to what happened when Russia first invaded Ukraine. The group's president, Cecilio Pedro, expressed hope investors will still consider the Philippines despite the rise in global conflict.
Nawawala po yung confidence ng mga businessmen to go around to do business because of potential war. Kami po dito sa Pilipinas, naniniwala kami, malaki pa rin ang opportunity dito sa Pilipinas. They should come and explore and look at potential here in the Philippines in spite of the war.
Meanwhile, the Philippine Agriculture Department believes the war in the Middle East will have minimal effect on local food production. The agency said in a statement it hopes for immediate resolution of the conflict, citing the Philippines' long-standing trade partnership with Israel. Israel has also been a strong export partner by purchasing desiccated coconut, pineapple juice, and concentrates from Filipino producers.